Psalms. reads, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou prepared the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil, my cup running over. Surely, the goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." People say,
amen. Amen. Let us all bow. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord God, here it is again. We come before you with bowed heads and humble hearts. First, to tell you, thank you, Heavenly Father. We thank you for another day, Heavenly Father. Thank you for allowing us this chance, this opportunity to be here. Thank you for putting it on our minds to want to be here, Heavenly Father. Now, you have brought us all the way here to the last Sunday in 2019. And we thank you, Heavenly Father. Because we couldn't have did it without you, Heavenly Father. Thank you for being that God that sets high and look low and looking beyond our faults, Heavenly Father. Bless us as you see fit, Heavenly Father. Thank you for our sick and our shut in, Father. Thank you for everyone that's under the sound of my voice right now, Heavenly Father. Bless our musicians, bless our praise team, have mercy upon our pastor, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Heavenly Father. You've been a good God, Heavenly Father. And you're good all the time, Father. Now, as we go through our services, Heavenly Father, we ask that you continue to bless us, Heavenly Father, so we can get what we need to continue on this march. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us all say together, amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Feel your power in this place. Oh, now
Thank you. Thank you. in praying and singing praises unto God. That was a great earthquake. Even after being whooped all night long, y'all come on and talk to me. Instead of being mad, none of them had prayed. And they prayed. Therefore, whosoever hear these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon the house, and it failed not, for it was founded upon a rock. And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them shall be likened unto a foolish shall be likened unto a foolish man which built his house on the sand, and the rain descended, and the floods came, and the wind blew and beat upon the house, and it failed, and great was the fall of it. And it came to pass when Jesus had ended these sayings, the people were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. You may be seated.
Amen.
I want to talk about just for a few minutes, amen. I was built to handle the storm.
Amen.
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
neighbor,
I was built
to handle
the storm.
The storm.
Amen. Yes.
In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 7, verses 24 through 27. At once it seemed like we are faced with two parables. But what appears to be two parables are in actuality a single parable. It is the contrasting of two opposing ideas concerning one event in an effort to paint a picture. Y'all pray with me.
Amen.
It shows us, amen, not only the negative side, but the positive as well.
Yes.
And it shows them with their individual results, leaving the decision of which example to follow in the hands of the hearer.
Right.
Y'all talk with me.
Amen.
Because Jesus here was talking to two different people. Y'all come on.
Amen.
A decision which cannot afford to be taken lightly. Our lives are too precious to be left up to hasty and thoughtless decisions, because it is our lack of foresight, amen, that lands of many a man in a strange and adverse predicament.
Yes, sir.
Had we not been so nearsighted, amen, we would have better prepared ourselves for the future.
Amen.
And many of us, amen, have lost a lot because we did not have a strong vision.
Yes.
Because the power of vision, amen, is actualized when you put things in place that will, at some future point in time, usher in the vision, amen, that you have.
Right.
At some point, you will see, amen, what you saw, amen, in your vision.
Yeah,
right. Y'all come and talk to me. You may not see it in the natural, but you can build safeguards against the different obstacles and circumstances that would and could come in and choke out the possibility, amen, of its fulfillment.
Yes.
So your vision, amen, if you put some effort and put something behind it, amen, then your vision will come, amen, into existence.
Yes.
Do I have any help?
Amen.
So the smart thing to do is to take the insight that you have been given and use it to shape and secure your future.
Right.
It is a travesty, amen, of sorts for God to give you all, amen, this word, and you do nothing with it. Y'all come and talk to me. God gave us 66 books of the Bible, amen, and many of us does nothing
with it.
Laziness, amen, will cause you to take shortcuts through life. Do I have any help? And shortcuts that, although they lighten the load and shorten the journey, amen, will hurt you in the long run. You got to look, amen, ahead to the long run. Amen. Because short-term stuff will not last. Come on,
forever.
Yeah. Which is why they always told me, amen, that acquisition always involved sacrifice.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. You got to give up something in order. Y'all come to talk to me to get something. Yeah. Because in order to gain something, you will have to give something up. But many times God would rather fall into the deep trap of the enemy that says that you can get something for nothing.
Yes.
He's always sneaking up on us,
trying
to tell us that we can get something for nothing.
Yes.
So Jesus warns us against that.
Yes.
Do I have any help?
Yes.
That's what I like about Jesus will not send us out without warning us of what can and will happen.
Yes,
these things, he said, I have spoken unto you.
Right.
He said, in this life ye shall have tribulation.
Right.
You're going to have some trouble in this life.
Right.
Yes.
That's right.
So he lets us know. He lets us know. Jesus talked to two men here in the text and with the same goal in mind. That was to build a house. Y'all come and talk to me. It was a parable, and a parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning, which God, when Jesus was really not talking about building a house, Jesus was talking about building a house. Y'all don't hear that. To handle the storm.
Yes,
y'all pray with me.
Amen.
Yeah. The one, amen, he says to be wise, and the one, amen, is declared to be foolish.
Yes,
both the wise and the foolish man have instructions and they have words.
Yes.
Y'all with me? So they are
the fact that there is a job
to do.
Everybody in here, amen, is familiar with there is a job to do. But God did not save you just to save you. But God saved you to help others to get saved. Now come on and talk to me.
Notice with me, amen, the difference, amen, of the methods.
Amen. If you look at the text, Jesus said that the wise man is like a man who hears what he has to say and does it.
Yeah.
That's a wise man. Uh-huh. This man, he builds his house on a rock, and he does so to his own benefit, amen, because sooner or later that will come a stormy situation. That's what Bible study is all about. That's what Sunday school is all about, that we can build our lives strong enough, amen, to handle the storm that's around the corner. So I guarantee you, if you're not in one now,
it's coming.
You got a storm.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you got a storm coming.
Oh, yes.
He said the rain fell and the wind blew and even began to flood and the elements of Mother Nature, amen, beat upon the house, but it didn't fall because what? It was built on rock.
Yes.
It didn't fall.
Yes.
Because it was built on a rock. And when you build your life on Jesus,
yes,
somebody said he is the sign that when you build your house or your life on a rock, then we are given a sharp contrast of a foolish man who heard his words and allowed them to fall to the ground. We are presented with a picture of a foolish man who saw sin and believed it to be a good place to build a house. He saw some sand and thought the sand was a good place to build a house. And the same stormy situation came to his destruction. The rain fell, the wind blew, and even it began to flood. And the elements of them, Mother Nature beat upon the house, and it fell.
Yes.
And the Bible said, and great was the fall. Y'all talk back to me.
Yes.
Yeah. He said the fall was great. And the foolish man lost everything that because he did not build the way Jesus told him to build.
Yes.
I remember another contractor by the name of Noah. Yet God told Noah to build an ark because it was going to rain. It had never rained before on the earth. Amen. But Noah did what God told him. And the wise man was willing to put forth an effort. He did not escape his responsibilities and labor and toil. And it did not matter how attractive, amen, the easier way looked. He knew that the easier way was not always the right thing. Y'all gonna talk to me? Which was symbolic, amen, of the natural tendency, amen, to gravitate to man's way of building a life.
Yes.
The foolish man chooses unwisely to avoid toil and labor.
Yeah,
he wanted something
for
nothing.
Uh-huh.
Y'all come on and talk to me.
Amen.
Yeah, he chooses to remain short short-sighted, amen, and only see things in the light of the present situation. Uh-huh. Ignoring the fact that, amen, there was coming something, amen, that will not, will no doubt try his efforts and to see whether or not, amen, they were merited. This foolish man. Yeah, and Jesus uses a parable, amen, to express a spiritual truth, a natural example. You see, in Palestine, it is common knowledge that the summer season was potent enough to dry up several of the rivers in the area, leaving only an attractive bed of sand in its place. An unsuspecting individual, or even a lazy one, amen, would look at this and say that was the perfect spot to be.
Yes, sir.
Only to encounter, amen, the harsh condition of the winter season that was enhanced by the rain and muds of the September, amen, and find that the sandy oasis was really a riverbed.
Yeah.
Y'all come on and talk to us. Which would, of course, cost him everything that he had worked for and leave him empty and without anything to show for his labor. But a wiser and more visual, amen, insightful man would see this layout and immediately look for a more stable foundation on which to build. Knowing that the house that he builds was to last a lifetime and not just a couple of months.
Yeah,
come on and talk to me. So he would look for a rock. And even if he had to labor and dig deep to find it, he'll look for a rock to build on. I'm here, amen, to get the material that I need. So he would look for a rock again. And Jesus says this, amen, is what occurred when wise men hear my words and do them. Two commandments which can be put into one word: obedience.
All right.
For nobody else.
Yes.
All right.
Amen.
Sound kind of harsh.
Amen.
But I'm here to get, amen, the materials, amen, that I need.
Yes.
Y'all talk to me.
Amen.
This is why it is important to be present, amen, of being the presence of the Word of God.
Oh, yes.
Y'all talk to me, for it is in the Word that there is strength and safety.
Yes.
Y'all talk to me. This is why when you come to the house of God, amen, you come with the intent that I am not here to make friends.
Yes, amen.
I'm here to get what I need to handle the storm that is on the way.
Yes.
Y'all come on and talk to me. So if I don't gossip with you,
yes,
y'all come on, don't be offended.
Yeah,
come on and talk to me. Because when the storm is over even if you don't make it. That's why I come. That's why y'all see me crying. That's why y'all see me praising God. I come to get what I need to handle the storm, because the storms, are on.
Yes, they are.
I came up the hard way. Brother Jackson, brother, I came up the hard way. There are times when you're going to have to toil and labor. But in the end, you'll be glad that you pressed your way. You'll be glad that you got what you need. So stop paying attention to people who have come up overnight. Talk somebody that come up overnight, you all looking at AD. I wish I had some help with
that.
And it may be that convenience, amen, will cost you too much.
Yes.
In the end.
Amen.
So you have to climb up the rough side of the mountain.
Yes, sir.
Just to know, amen, that when the storm comes your way, you'll know that beyond a reasonable doubt, it was worth.
Yes.
It was worth the climb. And in your life, there will be time, amen, when you can look back and see that everything that you have been toiling with and will only make it you able to handle.
Yes.
I've been through some stuff.
Yes.
I've seen some stuff.
Yes.
God brought me out.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Of some stuff.
Yes.
Because I had begun to build my life. All right.
Yes.
Why did he take the time? Have you ever sat and thought and looked back, amen, to where you was, to where you are today, and you ask yourself, why did he take the time to take care of me?
Yes.
No, you wasn't worth it.
Yes.
Yes,
no, you wasn't worth saving.
Yes.
But why? Unless the master architect put me together, I wouldn't have been able to withstand. Y'all come and talk to me. So he had to work on me a little longer. He had to work on me a little longer than he did some other folks. Amen. Because he knew that the storm that was coming my way, amen, was not going to ease up. On me.
Mm-hmm.
Wish I had some help.
Amen.
Oh, yeah, man.
He allowed me to stay where I was.
Yes,
a little while longer.
Uh-huh.
So here we see it in the text. He knew that time would test me.
Yes.
Y'all come on and talk to me.
Amen.
For it matters not how you look today. Amen. Time's going, amen, to tell if you are as strong as you look.
Amen.
Y'all talk to me.
Amen.
Yeah, because there are a whole lot of folk who look good and act strong. But the truth is that they are not built on a good foundation. Yeah, because if you know them, what happened, they will crumble and fall. Come here, doctor.
Amen.
You can tell when somebody's life. I'm on my way out here. I'm going to cut across the field.
Amen.
But I was built to
handle the storm.
In spite of the issues that
knew that I had enough energy to withstand it all.
Uh-huh.
And when you know that beyond a reasonable doubt that you have what you need on the inside,
yes.
There's certain confidence that calms your nerves.
Yes.
See, you reach rough spots in your life. You got to know what's on the
inside. Yes.
Yeah, when you know that you got God on,
yes,
the,
yes,
on the inside.
Oh yes.
You already got your help.
Oh yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, the psalmist said, amen. I lift up my eyes unto the hills which
come
at my help.
Oh, oh my help.
He said, oh my help.
Oh, my Lord.
Comes from,
yes,
the Lord.
Yes.
Which is why you don't have to panic. Get hysterical.
Yes.
Because I know that I'm prepared.
Yes.
So let the storm begin to,
yes,
rage.
Yes.
Because the Bible says in Proverbs 10 and 25 that when the storm is past, the wicked are no more.
Yes.
But the righteous is established,
yes,
forever.
Yes.
The storm. Yes. So tell the storm that I refuse to go down.
Yes.
Because my foundation is sure.
Yes.
And no matter how the wind may blow,
yes,
I'm going to hold to the foundation.
Yes.
In the thick of conflict, and it doesn't change how I live, because I know that no matter what the enemy sends my way, I was built.
Yes.
Why should I crumble under pressure? When the word tells me, be ye steadfast,
yes,
unmovable,
yes,
always abounding in the work of the Lord.
Yes.
So I've come to declare that I was built for this.
Yes.
This thing called life.
Yes.
Because life will deal you some cards,
yes,
amen, that you can't throw back in. You have to play them.
Yes.
I wish I had some help with you.
Yes.
I was built to handle whatever life from day.
Yeah.
Still that hope that lies within.
Yeah.
reassured as I keep my eyes on the distant shore. I know he'll lead and save me to that blessed place he has prepared. But if the storms don't cease, if the devil keeps trying to uproot me, if he keeps trying to overturn me, if he keeps trying to ruin me, if he keeps trying to destroy me, and if the winds keep blowing in my life, my soul,
yeah. Thank you.
Yes.
The happy. The
storm. Yes.
The storm.
Yes, Lord.
Bless my wife. When he comes.
Yes.
When he comes fast. When the devil comes.
Yes.
Just tell him.
Hallelujah.
Yes. The church.
Yes.
And
Amen.
say amen. Thank you.